So there's been a lot of talk recently about dark mode. That's going to be a new feature in the next version of macOS later this year that will allow you to have dark backgrounds like black backgrounds and light features like light buttons, white text, things like that. Using dark mode for writing can be very useful, but this new system-wide dark mode won't get you there. If you want to have dark mode in Pages, you kind of have to do it yourself. And you can do it now or even in any recent version of Pages. It's pretty easy. It takes about a minute to set up, but it can create an environment that's better for some people to write in. If you have a lot of writing to do, a novel, a long report, that kind of thing, you might want to try doing this. So here's how we're going to do it. First thing I want to do is I want to create a dark background. So let me change the zoom here to 50% so I can see the entire page. I'm going to insert a shape. I'm going to select the square shape. I'm going to move it to the upper left hand corner and drag its bottom right hand corner to take over the entire page. It locks into place really nicely so it's easy to fill the page exactly. Notice how it's pushed the text there into a second page. Don't worry about that because you're going to see that's not going to be a problem in a minute. I want to change the color here to black, and you may want to use a very dark gray and, you know, very light gray for the text, but I'll use just pure black right here. And now the next thing I want to do is I want to have that in the background of every page. So I'm going to go to Arrange, Section Masters, and Move Object to Section Master. So it's important I actually have that black background selected, that box selected. Once I do that, you can see the text in the second page disappear because now they're back here. Matter of fact, I can select them there. I can use Command A to make sure I have everything selected. Let's zoom back in to 125%. And you can see there is the text. So it's black text on a black background. So I want to go and change the text now with everything selected to white. And in order to kind of keep that throughout the entire document, I'm going to hit this update button next to body text. So I'm going to update the body text style so all body text is now white. So now I can type in white text on a black background. Now this kind of doesn't really complete it. I've still got lots of light elements here. So let's go and I can go to full screen mode. So let me do that. Now I'm going to go and change the zoom amount here to fit width. So it goes all the way across the screen. So that way I don't have any of that kind of light gray on the sides. And I can get rid of the toolbar if I really want to. I can go to view hide toolbar. It still comes up when I move my cursor there. Before I do view hide toolbar, I can actually click the format button here to get rid of the format bar there. And now I can do the hide toolbar. And now all I have is white text on a black background. So the idea here is to keep writing and use this as kind of a nice writing environment. I can always get back to the menu bar by going to the top of the screen with my cursor. And when I'm ready to undo it all, it's pretty quick to undo. Just show the toolbar first, maybe bring up the format bar here. I could go ahead and in the menus here, let me go out of full screen mode. And in the menu here, I could go to Arrange Section Masters, make Master Object Selectable. So now I can select this black background by selecting kind of off to the edge here. You can see it's grabbed it. Delete it. Let me turn that off. And I can go select my text. You can see it's white background, white text now on a white background. Change it to black. Update the body text. And there I go. I'm back where I was. Another way to do that is simply to use copy and paste instead. So I can go back. If I've got white text in a black background, if I go to a new Pages document and I paste it in, of course I'm going to get white text. But if instead I say paste and match style, I'll get black text because I'm pasting just the text into the current style, which is regular body text. So it's another way to do it there is to kind of have a dark mode writing environment that you can use and copy and paste text into whatever document you're actually working on.